Hi. So the other day my friend calls me. Hello? You want to hang out?
Oh, I can't. Sorry, I have work this afternoon.
Call in sick. I got the day off. We should go to the beach.
No, I can't. It doesn't work like that. I can't.
Whatever. I'm going to be there in an hour.
No, I can't.
I'll see you in an hour.
But
peer pressure. And the thing is, I don't know how people fake call in sick because when I'm actually sick, I still get really stressed cancelling work on the phone.
All right, how can I guarantee the person on the phone knows how sick I am? One, start with a cough.
Hello?
Hey.
Two, put on a voice like you're dying.
Hey, it's Natalie. And that's probably the way most sane people handle it. Not me though. I get so stressed and anxious about people thinking that I'm lying that I start to overcompensate and go nuts.
Okay, well, hope you feel better.
No, I'm really sick.
I know you are.
Turn on your computer.
Why?
I've sent you a link.
To a webcam I set up. You could watch me all day.
I don't feel comfortable watching you like this.
Watch me. Watch me.
Yeah, it would be the complete opposite of what anyone who's ever watched a woman stream her webcam could hope for. But the reason I get so stressed is because whenever anybody calls me to cancel work because they're sick, yeah, I don't believe them.
Hello?
Here we go.
Hello?
Hi, Ange, what's up?
Hi, I'm so sorry, I'm not feeling...
Yeah, whatever.
Oh my God, is that blood?
You know, I drive a hard bargain.
Hello?
Hi, Nat. I'm so sorry I didn't call earlier. I'm at the hospital. My grandmother passed away this morning.
Death certificate.
What?
Death certificate.
Oh, can I get it to you later?
Pixar, it didn't happen.
Is that blood?
And I think part of the reason I get so paranoid is because anyone can sound sick on the phone, right? That's easy. In fact, I remember once when I was too sick to go to an exam at uni, I took a photo of myself and sent it to my lecturer. Don't know why, but she told me never to do that again. But as you can imagine, when my friend asked me to call in sick and I wasn't actually sick, yeah, I freaked out.
Hello?
hello?
Hi, Nat?
Yeah, I'm so sorry. I'm not feeling very well today.
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that.
I'm very flabby.
Okay.
I couriered a box to you about 30 minutes ago express.
Oh, yeah, that just came in. It's on my desk right now. What is it?
Yeah, it's filled with tissues that have phlegm in it. My phlegm, because I'm sick.
What?
What?
Natalie, this is really unnecessary.
Yeah, I just don't want you to think that I'm faking it.
Why would I think that?
Because I am.
Sorry?
Nothing, bye.
Well, that was the weirdest call-in sick I've ever heard. Now get dressed, we're gonna go to the beach.
I'm not going to the beach. What if someone sees me?
No one's gonna see you, they're all at work.
No, I'm not risking that.
Relax, no one is gonna see, what are you doing?
I'm getting into my pajamas, I'm gonna make some soup, and then I'm gonna sit at home and feel sick.
Are you serious?
Deadly. Now move.
I'll see you on the webcam.
I don't know, are you guys confident when you call in sick? Because I can lie about a lot of things.
Hey Nat, do you hear like a ringing?
No, I can't hear anything.
Of course I hear something.
You should really see a specialist if you can hear something.
Oh my God.
Yeah, my cousin died because she started getting this ringing in her ears. It was horrific.
I just cannot call in sick, even if I legitimately am. I don't know, see if people call me, I just don't believe them. I'm like, I want to see you on Skype. 5 seconds, right now, on the floor, coughing up blood, snot everywhere, and that's just the foreplay. Yeah, I just get very paranoid, you know? When I made that video about spitting in food, all my friends then started to complain at restaurants, and then they would turn around and say,
are you worried they're gonna spit in our food now?
Yes, what are you trying to do, kill me? Anyway, I have two exciting pieces of information for you. One, I'm not wearing any pants, I'm joking. I am not wearing pants, but that's not the exciting news. One is I made a travel video and I put it up. I don't know if you saw it, but it had a different title and stuff. So check it out if you'd like to. It was about Monaco and it links to my new website and all that kind of cool jazz. And second piece of exciting information, I'm not wearing any underwear either. No, I know, exciting, not terrifying. A couple of months ago, Samsung Australia asked me to make some tutorials for the Samsung Galaxy S5, and they're now live on their YouTube channel if you want to check them out. If you have an S5, Please do, because I'm very excited because I learnt stuff about my phone. I now know how to do more than just call, hang up, and accidentally call. I'm very technology. So I'm going to link a video here, which is one of the features that I use all the time now. So if you have a phone, the S5, or if you just want to check them out, please do. And I hope you guys are well. Otherwise, I know this is too much information, Nat. You make too many videos too frequently. You're too good looking. You said none of those things. That's all right. Not. But yeah, I hope you guys are well and I'll see you soon. Hopefully on the next Wednesday in the Asia Pacific region and Tuesday everywhere else. Bye. Okay, it's Bono Music / comment time, and thank you all for your very disturbing restaurant stories. It was horrific. And Emma, firstly, hello. And secondly, I can't believe you wiped a sandwich on your butt. Wow, I hope that's a story that you tell your grandchildren, and I hope that that's what you're remembered for after your time on Earth. And Shinigami, carrying a dead cockroach in your pocket so that you can complain about a meal. Interesting, but at the end of the day, I don't know who wins in that because you have a dead cockroach in your pocket. I'll keep it in mind though. And Ghost Mosquito, you know what, mate? I will jot that one down in the idea book. Maybe, just maybe.